Kirk. They have this whole area roped off. You can see some of this tape. It goes around this entire block. Most of this has been cleared out. I want to show you guys down the block. There are still police cruisers out here. They've been stationed all over, making sure people don't move back into these spaces that they have cleared out. There have been as many as 100 people impacted by this sweep. The sweep involved police, public works, and a number of dump trucks. Denver's Department of Public Health and Environment says there are two objectives here. First, they want to connect people with resources and get them into shelters. A spokesperson for Public Health and Environment said four campers died during the cold spell we had a few weeks ago. The second goal is to deep clean this area.
There's a number of environmental and public health hazards, including feces, urine, litter. There's certainly a rodent population, biohazards, and we really just want to encourage everybody to get into shelter before this cold time of year comes up.
The effort is being described as the largest sweep of a homeless camp since November of 2016. That event resulted in a class action lawsuit filed in federal court to protect belongings of homeless people taken in such sweeps. They are now asking that the federal court hand a suit in order to give the city a 72-hour notice in the future so they would have time to file a temporary restraining order if they choose to. Now, this is a temporary closure. We're expecting all of this tape to be down in the next few days, and the Department of Public Health and Environment does hope that this is part of a long-term solution, not just a temporary one. Emily Allen, Fox 31.